Previously, we talked about two approaches to risk assessment, intuitive approaches and risk registers without aggregation. In this video, we're going to discuss risk registers with aggregation and full integrated risk modeling. Risk aggregation approaches aim to assess the total risk profile resulting from a set of risks and do not focus only on individual risks. Aggregation is beneficial in many ways, for example, to prioritize risk for mitigation action, or to have a measure of the possible impact of each risk on project-level metrics to assess the overall value of a project, including whether to proceed with it or not. Note that the quantitative risk register approach typically provides an overlay, meaning the results are ultimately added to those of a base case static model. And therefore, the approach is essentially a substitute for a full integrated risk model. However, an overlay model will usually focus only on the effect of the risks on certain key variables, most often just one, such as cost or revenue. When using risk registers for aggregation, there are two core approaches, which are discussed in the remainder of this section. Aggregation of static values, which is typically the product of probability and impact, and aggregation of impacts on occurrence, where the occurrence is modeled as a risk event, and the impact may either be a static value or an uncertain one. First, let's take a look at aggregation of static values. An example is given here. Here, the impact on occurrence are multiplied by the probability of occurrence to give an average impact. Note that risks may also be assigned to categories, for example, geography, department, or related to a specific risk driver. This way, they can be aggregated and presented by category as well as in total. The second approach is aggregation of risk-driven occurrences and their impacts. In this approach, the underlying nature of each risk is captured, meaning whether the risk happens or not. In general, simulation techniques would typically be required to capture the various combinations that may materialize. And in such cases, while capturing the random risk occurrence, one may also wish to reflect that the impact of each item could be an uncertain figure drawn from a range of possible values. Let's take a look at an example of such a model. In this model, both the occurrence of the risk event and the impact of each is uncertain. We have assumed that the impact uncertainty range is from negative 10% to positive 20% around the original base value. The figure on the left shows one sample of this model, and the figure on the right shows the distributions of outcomes after generating 10,000 such samples. There are a number of additional benefits in using risk-driven occurrences compared to the static aggregation. This approach more accurately reflects the underlying nature of the situation, as it captures many scenarios, all of which can occur, and one can assess the range of possible outcomes, not just average values. A frequent mistake is to directly add the impacts of risks that have been quantified at the line item level, as we did in the above example. This will often simply be invalid. The risk and impact definitions may need to be significantly modified compared to quantitative line item or non-aggregate approaches, and generally need to be made more precise. In the next video, we're going to discuss this further and introduce full integrated risk modeling.